discuss in the yesterday's class. And at the same time, during the formation of clouds and rains, textual page of 8, the white color entry box which has been given. In that you need to go with the water vapor, how the vapor is transferred, formation of the clouds. So in that one, we have been getting to know the formation of the clouds. So in this way, the inbox question I have been saying, you have to complete these also. So this one, in this one, what we have been get to know, this brown color inbox I have been sent you to complete, and this to complete the white color inbox, empty space, the diagram of 2.1, the evaporation diagram you need to do it out, and this also I have been sent you to complete out these aspects. And next, figure 2.2, the water cycle procedure, with the formation of the evaporation procedure, then again it reaches the water cycle, then again it goes back into the evaporation procedure. In that blue color inbox also we haven't get discussed the four important terms. So what are those four important terms which we will discuss is evaporation procedure, the next comes the water cycle procedure. This we haven't get discussed here, this blue color one. So already evaporation procedure we haven't get discussed. The next comes here the water cycle. This has been going to relate with the figure 2.2, the water cycle one. Then precipitation, then next comes here the humidity. So all these four important terminologies all we have been discussed in the previous class. Now next comes a lot here on page 9, other subtopic, the winds and the clouds. Winds and clouds. So as we all know, the clouds will get formed here, the complete aspect of one from here, one place, and
south.
map 1. So what is the map 1 term is? Monsoon winds in India.
So this is what about India. Next comes here the inverse, the questions which has been going to relate.
this inbox one which we have been going to deal now from the complete after this map here. This complete brown color box will be going to deal the answers now. And this map one is important. You need to draw and you need to go locate the following places during the revision. In the worksheet or part one. So textbook page 11 inbox question and answers. So there are two inbox questions. So first we will be going to read about the upper part in inbox question. So now the first question related to here is, towards which part of country would the winds take the clouds from the Bay of Bengal? So from the Bay of Bengal here, which place Bay of Bengal the clouds or the winds are been moving up? So the winds are moving to the here from indication it goes, it is been moving upwards to the northeastern direction. Once you need to go check through the arrow marks of this map and see. So the direction it includes here the first answer, the directions are northeastern part. Northeastern parts. Now the second question, towards which part of the country would the Arabian winds take the clouds from the Arabian Sea? So Arabian Sea, to which part of the winds have been moving and taking the clouds means it goes, it has been going from west direction towards the north direction, it is also been moving. So that is what north completely towards the north and western part it is been moving up. So answer is western parts. North western parts of India. Now coming to the third and third question. From which direction would the winds blow to bring monsoon rains to West Bengal, Lucknow, the next coming to your Delhi? So what are the directions it is coming to the rainfall here is West Bengal here, the next coming to Lucknow, Uttar Pradesh and northern parts of India, Delhi. What type means? Southeastern, north, western. So basically the complete four directions it is being including up. South, eastern, northwestern. Now coming to the last fourth answer. From which direction would the winds blow to bring monsoon rains to Mumbai, Hyderabad and Bengaluru? So what type of winds it is going to get towards the places like Mumbai, Maharashtra, Hyderabad, Telangana, the next come Bangalore, means Bengaluru, Karnataka. So western or southwestern parts of rains and at the same time northeastern it is going to be get existing. Why northeastern is here Telangana it is going to get existing basically the Hyderabad and southwestern means it is of Mumbai and Bengaluru. So basically it goes with southwestern to northeastern. So this is what about the winds which are being blowing up to our place up. Now next comes here the other one, rainfall in Telangana. So before the rainfall in Telangana, we will be going to have a look on the other inbox questions, five questions they have been gave you out. So what here it is, we will be going to deal about this one, rainfall in Telangana. So till now we haven't get discussed with this inbox the complete variations we have been get discussed here. These questions which I have been just now wrote on the complete board. This is what here the questions have been going to relate about this one. Now next subtopic is rainfall in Telangana. Now this brown color inbox on the other side we'll be going to deal about now. So rainfall in Telangana we will be going to have a look on before the screen of the board. Other subtopic now. Thank you. Now textbook page 11 in box question and answers. First question: in which months does it rain the most in your place? And this is three rainiest months. So basically, rainy season. So the months which includes basically June it gets start, but July, August, and September is also rainy. Most rainiest months in the year: July, August.
The rainfall has been going to get distributed. So here it is also been given the index. Green color it shows it is the rainfall from 100 centimeter and above, means higher the rainfall basically moderate. Now next coming to your yellow, lemonish green or yellowish color, between 60 to 99 centimeter, basically okay type of rainfall, which is been low rainfall. Next comes this red color areas, which is below 60 centimeter, means very low rainfall, which is been happening out in the complete state. Now next here the white color indication, it is been showing the inside the boundaries, district boundaries. The outer part, the higher darker one, the black color, it is the state boundary. So state is been, our state is surrounded by other states, Maharashtra, then Chhattisgarh, Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka. So this is what about the rainfall distribution of our state.
How many are you related, miss? There are three questions. What is the question here? The highest rainfall. Highest rainfall it is of 933 millimeters. Then next comes here. It is been going to relate again one more. The lowest is, which is here lowest is 605 millimeters, and this 933 in the year 1996, and the lowest it is been get included in the year 2002. Next and third question: during which 2 years did it get high rainfall? So high rainfall, which years it is been going to get means in the year 1996 and in the year 1998. So 2 years is 933 millimeters in the year 1996. Then next comes here 926 millimeters in the year of 1998. So these are, this is being of related to the inmost one, which is been going to get existing up. Now next comes here map 2 and distribution of annual rainfall in our state. This already we have get discussed out.
So regarding this one, this map, regarding this map of related, here they have been given out the two questions out here. So now the first one, what you have been going to do, which you have been existing which district? So basically Hyderabad. So in this Hyderabad, where it is here, this is the Hyderabad. So what rainfall? Low rainfall, which has been existing. And which town has the least highest rainfall? Means you have been going to write down the answer. Nalgunda, then next Jogalamma, Komaram, Bhim, Yadadri or Hyderabad. So that map you have been going to discuss here now. So these three related towards the questions which I am going to deal here in this one. Physical map, these three which I am going to deal now.
This is textbook, this is not inbox questions. So here three things have been given out. So on the textbook page of 12, the first one, look at the map given about showing the rainfall received in different parts of the Telangana. So in the first one, does your district receive heavy, moderate or low rainfall? The answer is about low rainfall. Which town has the highest or the least? So highest here you are going to write the green color one, and at the same time highest which includes Komaram Bhim is the highest one. Then next, least rainfall, least means very low rainfall, the very low rainfall it includes Nalgunda. So you have to look at the questions, you have brought in one, what is been given. So here, does your district receive heavy, moderate or low rainfall? This here, Hyderabad, which is in low rainfall. Low rainfall. The next comes here, the second one, highest. So we wrote in the title, but it is not. Highest rainfall here is